The embattled NSSF former managing director, Richard Byarugaba, returned to the seven-member ad hoc committee of parliament, which is inquiring into NSSF corruption allegations. Byarugaba told the committee that NSSF board is incompetent for the job, as people sitting on it lack expertise, while the competent management represented by the managing director has no voting rights.
Being the supervisor, my supervisor, this is a clear case of conflict. How would we as a fund, how would I, Richard Byarugaba, as the accounting officer, demand accountability from my supervisor?
So I'm still trying to understand why you say the board keeps making decisions on matters they don't understand.
I didn't say that.
Byarugaba also denounced the dual supervision of the fund by both the Labour Ministry and that of Finance, Planning and Economic Development, which was introduced by the recent amendment of the NSSF Act, saying it's the mother of the current wars. He argued that dual supervision has slowed down processes at the fund.
There were deferring approvals for real estate investment budget estimates. Conditions were set in there by the minister in total disregard of the mandate and without even consulting the Ministry of Finance, especially on the projects that were ongoing.
He indicated the minister, Betty Amongi, for interfering and frustrating approval of the budget, something he argued that derailed the implementation of investment.
Honourable Minister disregarded the established functioning governance structure by trying to ask the fund to provide 6 billion shillings to the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development for activities that the NSSF is already implementing.
Byarugaba also told the committee why he turned down request by the Minister of Gender for 40 billion shillings for the Grain Council and the contentious 6 billion shillings for the Minister of Gender to mobilise new savers, compliance and financial literacy. He explained that it was going to be difficult for NSSF to obtain accountability from its supervision.
When that 6 billion request came in, I opened my eyes and I asked myself, is this for real?
On the controversy surrounding his reappointment that was stayed by the minister, Byarugaba wondered how the minister blocked his retirement on grounds of clocking the retirement age of 60 years. Yet the same minister cleared the reappointment of the deputy managing director, Patrick Ayota, who is 62 years old.
Was that I should hand over my office to my deputy, who in fact was older than me, but it's okay, at 62. And whose contract had just been extended a few days ago, even without consulting the board or the board's recommendation.
He thus appealed to the probe committee chaired by Mwine Mpaka to recommend his reappointment, which was cleared by the board, and allow him to return to work pending investigations. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.